Hey everybody, how's it going? Kevin Freebie here, and today we're going to talk about this bass. All right, how's it going? It's been a minute. I've been doing lots of cool things, recorded on a couple of new tracks, did some studio stuff. I've actually been thankful to be getting back to a bunch of gigs. I know that I haven't posted a lesson video in a while, so I wanted to go ahead and get that done. But first, I wanted to go ahead and talk about this bass by Kiesel Guitars, all right? So what we're looking at here is what's called an AC50. And this is one of the first AC50s to bear the Kiesel logo. If I'm not mistaken, these basses aren't available anymore. They're really cool instruments. They're very specific instruments, but they're really cool. I've used this one to mimic kind of the big bass, okay? I'm going to be putting sound clips in and everything, and I'm going to, you know, be doing some close-ups of the bass and all sorts of fun stuff as this video goes on. But to give you just a quick idea of like some of the things that we're talking about. It has that real kind of uprighty tone. I absolutely love the bass for that. Especially since I haven't been able to play the upright in so long because of my hand problems that I spoke about on another one of the videos. So what happened is I got together with the fine folks at Kiesel Guitars a few years ago and I had them build me this bass. What we have here is a 5A figured walnut top. I've played a lot of pretty basses and I've owned a lot of pretty basses in my day. I have to say that this is right up there with the best of them. The walnut really pops like in a still photo. So what I'll do is I'll go ahead and cut to some stills of this bass in some direct sunlight or some really good light to where you can really get an idea of all the figure in the top. And that way you can kind of explore the true beauty of the instrument. Okay, so one of the things you might notice about this bass, I don't know if you could see it from here, but you'll definitely see in some of the stills, is that this has a lined ebony fingerboard. It's fretless bass, but I had them put ebony lines in instead of white lines or instead of maple. And one of the cool effects that you get is you can't see the lines from far away. So it keeps that really clean, beautiful, just fretless fingerboard that I really love the aesthetic of. But when you're actually playing it, you can see the black lines in the fingerboard. Therefore, it kind of helps you out with things like intonation, right? It has the same laminate on the headstock as it does for the top on the body. And then I have matching knobs as well. One of the things that I do want to mention is this thing's 100% hollow. You can hear it. The thing that's missing is the sound hole. I purposely left the sound hole out because what happens is if I'm playing with a drummer and playing in a live band situation, I wanted to avoid the chance of any feedback at all. And a lot of times that big sound hole right in the middle will kind of cause things to feedback at a high volume. And I wanted to avoid that completely. When we get to the back of the instrument, it's super pretty, but it's really functional. You have a mahogany body, once again, hollow. Then what we did is trying to mimic an upright. We did a one piece maple neck, okay? I'll explain that in a couple seconds a little more. I want to talk about these other things first. You have a separate compartment for the battery. You have string through body that is crucial if you ask me. I don't know if you can see from your angle, but there's a lot of figure in the maple neck. Once again, that's probably something that'll come out a little better in the still photos. So I'll go ahead and throw those up here. We did one piece maple because we wanted to mimic an upright instrument. We wanted it to be as organic sounding as possible. I typically prefer like a three-piece laminate neck for stability purposes, but one of the really cool things is we have a truss rod in here, and then Kiesel also put two graphite reinforcement rods, so the neck really doesn't move. I'm a big stickler on getting a bass set up very well and then not messing with it if I don't have to. Obviously, extremes in temperature and things like humidity are gonna affect it, but this bass affects it a lot less than most. I'm trying to think of anything that I didn't get to. Oh, there's a little ramp back here. I put it back here for soloing. It's just held on by double-sided tape. Real easy to get off. And black hardware. I think that's about it. What I'll go ahead and do is I'm gonna cut to the sounds of me playing so you can get an idea of what it does. And I would like to say that this bass can be yours. I'm gonna go ahead and sell this bass. If you're interested in it, please go ahead and shoot me a personal message and I will get you all the pricing and all that info. I really just wanted to describe the instrument. I wanted to go ahead and give you some audio in the background of the video. If you are interested in this, please go ahead and hit me up. I would be happy to tell you everything about it. To be honest, it's sat on the wall on a hanger a lot. Just because, unfortunately, I haven't been playing as much straight ahead jazz as I'd like to be. And because of that, I just haven't been getting to play the bass as much. It is a phenomenal instrument. If I played it more, I would totally still keep it, but I want to send it to a home where it's going to get a lot more love. And I really, truly believe in playing instruments that I own as opposed to just having them sit on the wall. Thank you so much for watching this video. It means so much to me. I understand that you could be watching a million other videos out there, but the fact that you're here spending time with me means a lot, okay? If you like the content that you're getting, go ahead and subscribe, click the like button. It really will ultimately help to just keep providing content on my channel. I will be posting quite often. I'll probably be posting another lesson later this week. I know I haven't been posting as frequently as I used to, but it's because things like rehearsals and gigs keep popping up as kind of the whole pandemic thing is slowing down. And I've been doing a bunch of gigs, doing some recording work, and it just kind of took me away from the video thing, but I will be making up for it, I promise. Once again, thank you for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you on the next video. The people, 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 the people,